We're asked to graph y is equal to x squared minus x minus 6 by plotting points. So let's just make a table. Let's just pick some x values and figure out what y is going to be based on this relation up here. So let's figure out what y is going to be. So let's just start x at, I don't know, let's start at negative 3. So if x is negative 3, then y is going to be negative 3 squared is 9. Minus negative 3, so that's plus 3, minus 6. So what is that? 9 plus 3 is 12, minus 6, this is equal to 6. Then we get, let's just keep doing going before we plot any points. So then we have negative 2. If x is equal to negative 2, then y is negative 2 squared, which is 4, minus negative 2. So that's plus 2, minus 6. So in that situation, we have 4 plus 2 minus 6, that's equal to 0. Then if x is equal to negative 1, we have negative 1 squared, which is positive 1, minus negative 1, which is another positive 1. Then we have minus 6. 2 minus 6 is equal to negative 4. Let's go to 0. If x is equal to 0, these two terms are 0, and then y is equal to negative 6. Let's go all the way to positive 3. If x is equal to 1, we have 1 squared minus 1. Those cancel out. And then you have just a negative 6 there. Just a negative 6 there. And then if we have x is equal to 2, we have 2 squared, which is 4, minus 2, minus 6. So 4 minus 2 is 2, minus 6 is equal to negative 4. And then if x is equal to 3, we have 3 squared, which is 9, minus 3, right? 9 minus 3 minus 6. Well, that's going to be equal to 0. So let's plot these points. So let me do it in a dark color here. So the first point is negative 3 comma 6. So this is my x-axis right here. This is my y-axis. So negative 3 is negative 1, 2, 3 comma 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So it will be right over there. That's this point over here. Then the next one is negative 2 comma 0. So negative 2, and then we don't move up in the y direction at all. Then we have negative 1 comma negative 4. Negative 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, negative 4 is right over there. Then we have 0, negative 6. 0, x is 0, y is negative 6. So it's that point right there. Then we have 1, negative 6. So x is 1, y is negative 6. And then what do we have? We have 2, negative 4. So x is 2, y is negative 4. And x is 3, y is 0. So you can see if we just connect these plots, we get a bit of a curve. We get a bit of a U shape. And the U shape will look like this. Do my best to draw it. This is always the hardest part. Drawing, connecting the dots. So you, let me just do it in one nice. So you get a U shape that looks something like that. I could do a better job of drawing that, I'm sure. Let me do one last shot at this. So let me just draw as good of a U shape as possible. It'll just keep going like that. So you get this U shape over here. And this U shape, which is the general shape of these quadratic functions right here, this is called a parabola. So that U shape is called a parabola. And in the future, we'll see better ways to graph it, so you don't have to just plot a bunch of points. But it's good to see the general shape. And we get that general shape just by trying out a bunch of x values and figuring out the corresponding y values.